The word that immediately comes to mind when discussing Starship V3? Monumental. It's fitting considering it's the largest and most technologically advanced iteration of SpaceX's groundbreaking spacecraft to date. However, one might be surprised to learn that this substantial upgrade goes beyond mere dimensions. It will also incorporate revolutionary improvements designed to increase Starship's efficiency and power through the implementation of a new hot staging system. What prompted SpaceX to implement this significant hot staging upgrade? Let's dive deeper in today's episode of NR Studio. As we approach 2025, SpaceX is poised to begin the evolution towards Starship V2. However, the most exciting aspect is that the conceptualization of V3 is already underway. Shifts have already occurred with the ship's components, more so than I can say about the thrusters. However, it's highly likely that these improvements will occur in the near future. The new iteration marks the introduction of groundbreaking advancements. V3 won't just be bigger. It will also incorporate significant advancements in its hot staging system. Hot staging was implemented after Flight 1 as a critical upgrade intended to optimize Starship's performance and stability. The system incorporates an intermediate ring located between the two stages, equipped with specially designed vents to divert heat and pressure from the ship's second stage engine. This system maintains the integrity of the booster's upper stage while facilitating a smoother stage separation, avoiding the problems experienced during Starship's maiden flight. However, after several launches, it became clear that SpaceX was not entirely satisfied with the existing design. The existing hot staging ring presented certain limitations that needed to be addressed. Initially, its compact length facilitated the effects of heat and pressure on various booster components, especially the fins. This could affect the control surfaces and complicate booster recovery. Furthermore, the vent dimensions were relatively modest, resulting in less efficient heat and pressure dissipation. Such a scenario could result in undue stress on the vehicle after separation. Third, the design of the system was still relatively complex, requiring SpaceX to jettison it mid-flight to increase the booster's agility. However, given that the ultimate goal was full reusability, jettisoning components would be counterproductive. To address these challenges, a re-engineered hot staging system was proposed. The new design would closely resemble the Soviet N1 rocket architecture, albeit with significant improvements, as it is widely recognized that greater scale often accompanies greater advantages. The ring extension will increase the protection of critical components, such as the grill fins. This modification, in conjunction with repositioning the grid fins lower on the booster, will effectively mitigate the impact of the spacecraft's engine exhaust on the booster throughout the stages of separation and descent. The vents will be optimized in size to enhance the efficiency of heat and pressure dissipation. This enhancement facilitates a more seamless separation process while alleviating undue stress on both phases. Furthermore, the revamped design exhibits a notable simplification, thereby facilitating manufacturing, integration, and refurbishment between flights. A significant benefit of this enhanced hot staging system lies in its diminished weight. A more streamlined design indicates that SpaceX may no longer require the expulsion of the ring after separation. Alternatively, it may descend back to Earth alongside the booster, thereby rendering full reusability more understated and considered. The innovative design enhances the stage separation process of the Starship, thereby optimizing the condition of both the booster and the spacecraft for their designated missions. A seemingly minor adjustment, yet one that yields considerable effects, epitomizes SpaceX's ongoing commitment to innovation. Should the new hot staging system be incorporated in version 3, its introduction could potentially occur by year's end. In the previous year, Musk elaborated on V3 in a presentation at Starbase, elucidating SpaceX's future aspirations for Starship in both Texas and Florida. Recently, NASA officials indicated that V3 will be pivotal in the forthcoming refueling infrastructure, anticipated to be operational by the end of the year. This indicates that V3 must be prepared by that time frame, or ideally sooner, to effectively facilitate these missions. Nonetheless, it is conceivable that the enhanced hot staging system may make its debut earlier than anticipated. In Musk's presentation, Starship V2 was showcased featuring a hot staging ring akin to that of V3S. At present, boosters B15 and B16 seem to be configured in the V1 format. This indicates that B17, currently in the construction phase, has the potential to be the inaugural project to invigorate the new system. Considering SpaceX's accelerated production rate, this prototype may be finalized as soon as March or April. Should this be the case, the emergence of the innovative hot staging system may be imminent. Are you eager to witness this enhancement in action? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. Subsequently, kindly engage with our video by liking it and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on the progress of SpaceX's developmental endeavors. However, hot staging is not the sole aspect undergoing a transformation. Starship V3 is set to unveil a range of noteworthy enhancements. One of the most noteworthy transformations is its dimensions. The V3 will rise to a height of 150 meters, featuring a super heavy component measuring 80.2 meters, while the vessel itself will be a more modest 69.8 meters. This elevation inherently suggests an augmented fuel capacity. Booster V3 is designed to accommodate slightly in excess of 000 tons of fuel, surpassing V1 by 750 tons and V2 by 00 tons. Concurrently, Ship V3 is designed to accommodate 2,300 tons of fuel, representing an increase of 1,100 tons relative to V1 and 800 tons compared to V2. This enhancement will empower Starship to extend its travel range, enhance its delivery capacity, and significantly contribute to the establishment of the refueling infrastructure envisioned by SpaceX. With this enhanced capacity, V3 is anticipated to surpass the 200-ton payload threshold, a milestone that SpaceX has yet to completely attain with V1 and V2. The enhanced capacity to transport a greater volume of cargo and an increased number of passengers per flight will undoubtedly elevate Starship's competitiveness. However, overtaking all other vehicles presently in operation. In the long run, this progress will facilitate a more expedient establishment of a lunar base and, ultimately, the colonization of Mars. The subsequent and most intriguing enhancement in V3 pertains to its augmented thrust capability. The anticipated Starship V3 is projected to utilize the Raptor 3 engine, or potentially an even more potent variant, with the initial stage comprising 39 engines that will propel the total liftoff weight beyond 10,000 tons. This represents threefold the power of the iconic Saturn V. This exceptional capability positions Starship V3 as a vanguard in the realm of space exploration, in the most literal sense. Given these advancements, it is highly probable that SpaceX will employ V3 for critical missions. In addition to its role in bolstering the refueling system, it may also provide the foundational support for the enhanced Starship HLS utilized in NASA's Artemis lunar missions. As SpaceX sets its sights on executing its inaugural uncrewed Mars mission in the next 2 years, followed by its first crewed mission within a 4-year timeframe, Starship V3 is anticipated to be instrumental in these groundbreaking endeavors. However, Starship is merely one component of the larger equation. The introduction of V3 will necessitate enhancements to various other essential supporting systems. Initially, it is probable that new launch towers will require construction. Tower A at Starbase currently reaches a height of 15 meters, while Tower B exceeds it marginally. Nonetheless, neither option will suffice to accommodate the augmented height of V3 in relation to stacking, launching, or even catching. Given the current pace of development, it will likely become essential to construct a new tower that stands around 170 meters in height, or potentially even greater. However, considering SpaceX's swift construction velocity, it is plausible that this new tower may materialize within the year. This enhancement will be seamlessly incorporated into SpaceX's broader expansion strategy for Starbase, in conjunction with the development of the new Starship launch infrastructure in Florida. In conjunction with the launch tower, it is imperative that ground support systems are fortified to withstand the substantial forces exerted by V3. The flame trench system is poised for significant enhancements aimed at optimizing the efficient diversion of exhaust energy during both testing and liftoff. The tank farm will undergo expansion to enhance its capacity for fuel storage, thereby accommodating the augmented volume necessary for each mission. Certainly, the production chain is poised for a significant revamp as Star Factory, SpaceX's specialized Starship manufacturing hub, is set to thrive. Enhanced vertical and horizontal dimensions for the assembly bays will be requisite to accommodate the revised design. Plans for the construction of Gigabay, representing a pivotal advancement in the evolution of Starship's assembly facility, have been meticulously developed for both Starbase and Cape Canaveral, reinforcing SpaceX's pledge to achieve unparalleled mass production of the Titanic rocket ship. Undeniably, the advent of Starship V3 and its innovative hot staging system heralds the onset of a significant new epoch in space exploration. Given the plethora of advancements on the horizon, do you believe you are adequately prepared for the forthcoming developments? To conclude our daily update, let us examine last year's global space launch performance and consider the expectations for this year. In 2002, the global landscape observed a remarkable total of 259 successful orbital missions, marking the fourth consecutive year of unprecedented launch activity. This equates to a rocket launch occurring every 3 hours. Heather Pringle, the CEO of the Space Foundation, underscored the importance of this swift expansion by remarking that there is ample reason to trust in the positive momentum of the space economy. A highly effective method for sustaining that growth is to consistently expand our capacity to welcome others into our fold. The launch statistics from the previous year further highlighted SpaceX's unequivocal superiority in the industry. The company executed 132 Falcon 9 missions and conducted 2 Falcon Heavy flights, thus representing over 50% of all global launches. Roughly 90% of these flights contributed to the advancement of Starlink, the satellite internet constellation developed by SpaceX. This remarkable ability has established SpaceX as an essential launch partner for NASA in the United States. The Department of Defense is instrumental in augmenting military spacecraft deployments by an impressive 86%. Consequently, the United States has reinforced its preeminence in the space sector, clearly demonstrating to China its supremacy in the realm of spaceflight. Anticipating the year 2025, the Space Report forecasts an elevated frequency of launches. Earth's emergence is anticipated to stem from Europe's autonomous launch initiatives alongside a heightened launch frequency originating from the United States, alongside China. In the United States, a myriad of forthcoming launch vehicles is poised to significantly enhance this burgeoning momentum. Please provide the text you would like me to rewrite. Blue Origin's New Glenn, which debuted successfully this year, along with ULA's Vulcan rocket, will significantly increase operational activity. Meanwhile, established rockets such as the Falcon 9 and Electron are poised to increase their launch frequency. SpaceX is on track to conduct more than 180 Falcon launches by 2025, complemented by a significant increase in Starship missions. To achieve this goal, the FCC is developing a new regulatory framework that will allow the company to conduct space launches without the need to obtain provisional authorization for each individual mission. In contrast, China is aiming to reach the remarkable milestone of 100 launches this year, following its impressive tally of nearly 70 in 2002. The country is progressively increasing its competence in government and commercial spaceflight. Simultaneously in Europe, the highly anticipated Ariane 6 and Vega C are set to begin regular operations, significantly enhancing the continent's capacity to compete in the burgeoning commercial launch sector. Given these advances, 2025 is poised to emerge as one of the most exciting years in the annals of aerospace history. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next video.